Hello, I'm David Brown from the Solidworks training team. This video presents a project that you can use to hone your Solidworks or X-Design skills and is easy to make if you have a basic 3D printer. The key aspects of this design that I will focus on are multi-body part design, exporting solid bodies, and 3D printing. Let's get started. I used multi-body part techniques for this project, as you can see by examining the solid bodies folder. I began by creating a representation of the board that I plan to use as the shelf, which is readily available at the local supply store. The first feature of the bracket starts with a simple sketch on the front plane. It is set back from the front edge a small amount and is dimensioned to create a symmetrical bracket. I use the sketch to create an extrude that is offset from the sketch plane. This allows me to easily adjust the position of the bracket under the board by changing this dimension. Next, I created the support feature, with enough thickness to leave room for mounting holes. Then I added a small fillet to finish the design. Hole wizard features are used to create mounting holes for attaching the shelf to the wall and the brackets to the shelf. I mirrored the bracket body using the front plane to create the other side. I created this shelf for my grandson and wanted to personalize it with his name. I placed a sketch on the side face of the bracket and added sketch text to a curve offset from the curved edge of the bracket. This is used as a cut for an inlay. I did the same thing to the other side. To create the letters, I converted the sketch entities of the text cut and extruded them a thickness a little less than the depth of the cut. When the letters are 3D printed, this will ensure a flush fit when they are pressed into the side of the bracket. I repeated this for the other side. The last feature in the tree is a Move Copy Body feature, which I added so that I could create some of the images for this video. Once the design is complete, I need to export the individual bodies to prepare them for printing. Because the bracket is symmetrical, I really only needed to create one side and export the bodies for that side. All I need is the bracket and each of the letters. Then print two copies of each. I chose to create both sides in this model so that I could visualize the project in its entirety. I'll right-click a body and select Insert into New Part from the context menu. Click the Browse button and give it a name. I have already done this for this design, so I will cancel this command. Once the part is open, I need to save it to a file type my 3D printer slicer software understands, an STL file. Click Save As, choose the file type from the list, and click Save. I oriented the bracket to print flat. Organic supports are used to assist in the counterbore holes. As you can see in this view of the bottom, support material is needed in the text cuts. By making the cut a little deeper than the thickness of the inlay letters, I am certain that any residual material from the cleanup process will not interfere with the inlay. I simply choose a different color filament for the inlay letters to achieve the desired effect. The project discussed in this video was for a shelf designed for my grandson's room according to his specifications. Another possible design for a 3D printed shelf bracket is one that I designed using X-Design. This one attaches to a ready-made shelf purchased at a local supply store and sits on my desk. It is perfect to support multiple monitors and increases the efficiency of my work area. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to this channel for upcoming projects in the Useful SolidWorks Design Projects You Can Make playlist. And if you found this content helpful, visit the site below to access more content for designing with SolidWorks.